Worst thing about social distancing is if you're doing it right and keeping a curve-flattening human exclusion zone around yourself, it's probably been a while since you've had a good hug, especially if you live alone.
A good tight hug triggers the release of oxytocin, a hormone essential for a sense of well-being. It also reduces conflict and stress and helps us sleep well.
Another important thing that oxytocin is rather famous for is that it plays a really key role in promoting a sense of social bonding and social connectedness.
But for anyone in isolation by themselves, hugs are going to be in real short supply, and that can take its toll.
We know that when people are lonely, that they have an increased risk of a whole range of different disorders, cardiovascular disease, obviously mental health disorders, and can even compromise people's immune system, which is something we want to avoid right now.
The good news is that science tells us the good vibes we get from hugs can be recreated in other ways that won't mess up your social distancing. First up, presents. Giving a gift, whether it's a present or flowers, taking time to help someone out gives us a huge shot of endorphins. Studies have found we feel a greater sense of happiness when we spend money on others as opposed to buying ourselves crap we don't need. Did somebody say dogs? Getting up close and personal to a four-legged friend can be just as good as a squeeze from a two-legged friend. The effect is especially good if you're the doggo's owner, but if you identify as a dog lover, patting any old pooch will get your oxytocin up.
When dogs and their humans looked into each other's eyes, they both showed an increase in oxytocin levels. So there really might be something to those puppy dog eyes.
And last but not least, the L word. I love you. Say it loud, tell your friends, tell your mum, tell your dad, hell, tell Bob the courier who just delivered 20 kilos of chocolate. It doesn't matter. As long as you mean it, you'll get all those feel-good chemicals rushing to your brain.
So go on, say it to someone right now.
Well, go on then.
Love you, Rach.
I love you guys. I love you. I miss you.
Do you know what's funny? And we miss you too. I do miss personal connection so much, but I think it's funny seeing a lot of the feedback. People saying, nah, I'm not looking forward to all those huggy people coming at me again. Dane says, what's the deal with hugging? I hate people invading my personal space. There might be some people that quite like the fact that in life now they don't have people coming in for kisses and hugs.
Oh, yeah. There's going to be people who are keen for it, like this one over here.
Me and my wandering hands.
Well, that's HR. We got HR.
As for replacements for hugs, this is one of my favourite initiatives that's happened. There have been a lot of great initiatives through this period, but one of my favourites is this. It's called Hug in a Mug. So you can buy this. So I care a lot about mugs. It's a good quality mug.
Yeah.
And it's a hug in a mug because I can't give you one. So the idea is you buy this and then you can send it to whoever it is that you want to give a hug to, which
cute.
Is a great idea on its own, but it's better than that because every purchase of a mug, you can also buy T-shirts to do it, we'll buy a coffee for a frontline health worker.
Oh.
And also, or could buy a meal for six people who are doing it tough right now.
Wow.
So Oz Harvest do this sort of thing quite often, so they've partnered with these guys. It's a fantastic initiative, and I reckon just go and do it.
I saw your mocker in that in your office.
Yeah, that's right. So anyway, hugsandheroes.com.au is the website.
Awesome. Great.